We have already done square roots, so they should be in your book somewhere, please. Yes? And you should kind of realize, people, that when it comes to square roots, here's a little mathematical stuff for you. Square roots that work out, for example, the square root of 1 is what? 1, right? The square root of 2, the square root of 3, the square root of 4. The square root of 4 works out. What times what number gives you 4? Anybody? What times what? The one same number times 12 gives you 4. Now, it's a tough one, Elijah.
2.
Now, so the question is, if the square root of 1 equals 1 and the square root of 4 equals 2, what does the square root of 2 and the square root of 3 give you? Well, and to draw this, show it to you in a little different way here. If the square root of 1 is 1, here's our number line, and the square root of 4 is 2, that means the square root of 2 and the square root of 3 have to fall somewhere between 1 and 2, right? And here is the deal with these guys here. I'll throw a little math at you. The square root of 2 and the square root of 3, in any square root that doesn't work out perfectly, any square root that doesn't work out perfectly is called irrational. Now, I might call some of you irrational. Does anybody know what the word irrational means? You know what the word rational means? If your behavior is rational or if your behavior is irrational, what's the difference between those two? Anybody? You're sixth graders, you should understand that. Anybody? Riding irrational would be what?
Bad.
In what sense?
Like, too much.
If your behavior is rational, it means it's acceptable, it makes sense. If you're acting irrationally, it's not a good thing if your parents tell you that or your teacher. That means what you're doing, we don't have any reason or we don't understand why you're doing that. Same thing with numbers. These two are rational because they work out to 1 and 2. These two here, ones that don't work out, are irrational because if you type that into a calculator, you will end up getting a decimal that never ends. It's irrational. We can't even think of it because it just doesn't, it never works out. In fact, I could do it for you if you want. And on this thing here, calculator, if you can see this, the square root of 2, if you look here, it says 1.414213562373. And the only reason that stops there is because this calculator is only good for that many digits. If you had a calculator that never stopped, it would never stop. Okay. So this square root of 2 and the square root of 3 are irrational. They don't work out perfectly. But, and that's what today's lesson is about, when you come up with square roots that don't work out, you should be able to estimate what they are. Okay. And in order to estimate them, you know that the square root of 2 and the square root of 3 have to be between 1 and 2. So that's how you would estimate it. You'd probably say the square root of 3 might be closer to 2 than it is to 3, and the square root of 2 is probably close to 1. Okay, so sometimes when it comes to square roots, you're going to have to kind of get close to that. For example, if I said the square root of 50, if I told you to estimate the square root of 50 to the nearest whole number, in order to do that, you have to think about the square roots that do work out. So you kind of got to know the perfect squares. What is a square root that's awful close to 50 that does work out? It's the same number times the same number. And if you don't know, you might want to sit down and write, jot down all of them that work out in your head. Square root of 50, Aubrey, is close to? Square root of 25 is here. That's 5 times 5. What's 6 times 6? Square root of 36. What's 7 times 7? 49. square root of 49, and what's 8 times 8?
64.
Square root of 64. So if I were asking you the square root of 50, which of those square roots is the closest to, you would tell me it's much closer to 49 than it is 64. So if you were estimating it, that's why we use this little squiggly equal sign, it is close to 7. Okay. So I suppose you should probably know all the perfect squares. You know, square root 9 is the square root of 81. 10 is 100. How about 11? Everybody? 121. 12 is 144. 13? 169. 14? 14 times 14, what is it? It's 196. 15? 225, I think. 20 is the square root of 400. 30 is the square root of 900. So let's look at some of the questions they do ask you. How about the square root of 80? And they're going to ask you, the square root of 80 is between what two whole numbers? The square root of 80 has to fall between what two whole numbers on a number line? So you need to think of what perfect square is close to that, above and below it. Maddie Roth?
64 and 81.
Okay, the square root of 80 is between the perfect square of 64, which is 8, and the square root of 81, which is 9. So the square root of 80 has to fall between 8 and 9. Now, which one would it probably be closer to, 8 or 9? Lainey?
9.
9, because it's only one way from the square root of 81. But they'll ask you which two it's between. How about the square root of 10? Again, it's an irrational number. But the square root of 10 is between what two whole numbers? Square root of 10 is between what two whole numbers? Riley?
9 and 12.
Well, it's between the square root of 9, which is 3, and the square root of 12, but what's the next one after 3? 4 times 4 is square root of 16, which is 4. So the square root of 10 is between 3 and 4. Now in that case, which one's it probably closer to? Well, it's closer to 9 than it is 16, so it's probably closer to the whole number. How about 70? The square root of 70 would be between what and what? Looking at your perfect squares. Isabel? Yeah, because 64, the square root of 64 is 8, and the 9 is the square root of 81, so it has to be between 8 and 9. How about, they ask us some hard ones here. How about this one, the square root of 961? Square root of 961. By the way, this one works out evenly. What would be the quickest way, besides a calculator, to figure out what the square root of 961 is? Start big, and then work your way down. Elijah, what's your first thought? No, I wouldn't do that, because the square roots and division don't have anything to do with each other. Don't think about division. I would start with the big numbers first. Think about this. What's 20 times 20? 400. So the square root of 400 is 20, so you know it's got to be bigger than that. Then I might go 30. What's 30 times 30? 900. so you know that 961 has to be bigger than that. Well, if you did 40 times 40, you're getting into 1600. So you know it has to be between 30 and 40, right? So now pick one. First of all, it has to be the same number that multiplied by itself gives you a 1 at the end. What numbers when you multiply the same number will give you a 1 at the end? So what's 1 times 1? Gives you a 1. 2 times 2 is? In other words, this. Here's your choices. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39. We know 40 is too big. Okay? Know this. The last digit of these numbers, when you multiply two numbers, two of the same number together, okay, your last digit, what's 9 times 9? Because if I multiply 39 times 39, 9 times 9 is 81, right?
Yeah.
The last digit in the number I get when I multiply is going to be a 1. Why? Because when I get to the next column, remember I always have to start with a 0, so when I add them together, this number is going to end with a 1. This number is going to end with a 8 times 8 is, it's going to end with a 4. This is going to end with a 9. This is going to end with a 6. This is going to end with a 5. This is going to end with a 6. This is going to end with a 9. This is going to end with a 4. And this is going to end with a 1. So if I know that 961 works out perfectly, it either has to be 39 or 31 because those are the only two that are between 30 and and 40 that are going to end with a 1 like this does. So then you think, okay, well, 900 or 1600, which one is it probably closer to? Is it going to be 31 times 31 or 39 times 39? What is 31 times 31? Oh, look, 961. So what is this? The square root of 961 is 31. That's just the way. Now, you could try every number humanly possible and try to figure it out, but how about this one? 484. The square root of 484. Again, thinking about it, what two big numbers does it have to be between? 10 times 10 is 100. 20 times 20 is 400. 30 times 30 is 900. You know it has to be between what? Which of those, Lainey? It's between 20 and 30. Now, which one of those, when you multiply together, is going to end in a 4? That's what you have to think about. How many different ways can you get 4? If you have 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, and 29, which of those will end with a 4? 8 times 8 is 64, and 2 times 2 is 64. Which one of those, and again, you might have to then try and error on this. Well, let's try. What's 28 times 28? 64 ends in a 4. Good. 16, 22, 0, 56. Oh, that is 784. Way too big. So 22 times 22 is, well, look at all the 4s. 4, 4, 4, 4. 484. So that's 22. Lots of trial and or error. Oh, the time, where has it gone?